Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. Today I am going to present the topic Bihar Heritage Sites. So let's proceed to the presentation. First heritage site is Nalanda Mahavihar University, Nalanda. One of the most important UNESCO sites of Bihar is the Nalanda Mahavihar University. Nalanda was a Buddhist monastery during the 5th century. The city houses one of the world's oldest and finest residential universities, which itself was an architectural masterpiece. In addition to this, the complex houses a charming little museum, which has a collection of several of original Buddhist stupas, Hindu and Buddhist bronzes, coins, terracotta jars, a sample of burnt rice, etc. The most popular Mahavihar of the ancient time, a significant Buddhist seat of academic excellence and a modest pilgrim center, all wrapped in a wisp of spirituality, Nalanda continues to be an equally enriching location in the present. It offers vibrant substance of spirituality, history, culture, architecture and tourism. Nalanda University was the center of advanced Vedic learning till 12th century. Students from Central Asia, Tibet, China and Korea came to Nalanda University for higher education. The major subject of the university was Mahayana, Sanskrit, grammar, Vedas, medicine, logic and Samakhya. Nalanda University was at peak stage when it was destroyed by the army of Bakhtiar Khilji. The district is believed to be a cradle of religions. Apart from Buddhism, it is an important center for Jainism, Hinduism and Sufism as well. Considering the rich heritage and the historical importance, it is a hot tourist destination. Second heritage site is Huanshang Memorial Hall, Nalanda. Built as a dedication to the Chinese scholar Huanshang, this memorial is a distinct reminder of the architectural site of the Nalanda University. One will find multiple writings of Huanshang preserved here. The hall is well maintained and describes the life and travels of a Chinese scholar. The hall has a huge statue of Huanshang in the center of the courtyard with a beautifully crafted doorway and a meditation hall. The hall has a description of Huanshang's life and travel from India to China. It is located in Nalanda, Bihar. This beautiful memorial hall can be visited at any time of the year. There is also a huge well next to the statue, which attracts the tourist more. Next heritage site is Mahabodhi Temple, Bodh Gaya. Bodh Gaya is a Buddhist pilgrimage site in Gaya district of Bihar. Famous for the Mahabodhi Temple, it was here under the Bodhi tree that Gautam Buddha attained enlightenment. It is now one of the UNESCO World Heritage Sites, and a lot of foreign countries, including Japan and China, have helped the Indian government in building facilities for the Buddhist pilgrims. The place is bustling with pilgrims all through the year from India and abroad, who come to pay their homage in monasteries, temples and remnants of Bodhi tree. Located near the river Niranjana, Bodh Gaya was earlier known as Uruvela. It was also known as Sambodhi, Vrajasana or Mahabodhi until the 18th century. It is one of the four important Buddhist sites that include Kushinagar, Lumbini and Sarnath. These slides represent the pictures of Mahabodhi Temple, Lord Buddha and Mahabodhi Tree and architectural designs of Mahabodhi Temple. Great Buddha Statue. The Great Buddha Statue is situated in Bodh Gaya, Bihar. The statue stands 19.5 meter tall. The statue is in Dhyan Mudra pose, also known as meditation pose. The statue looks like it is seated in lotus in the open air. It took 12,000 masons to complete in 7 years. The statue is made from sandstone blocks and red granite and is one of the largest statues in India. The statue was inaugurated by the 14th Dalai Lama on 18th November 1989. It is one of the famous tourist spots in India. Next heritage site is Rajgir. Rajgir is a town where the air that surrounds its beautiful scenery carries hints of spirituality and vibrant hues of history with links with both Buddhism and Jainism. Set in a green valley and surrounded by rocky hills, Rajgir is a spiritual town with natural serenity amongst the dense forests, mysterious caves and springs. Rajgir houses many religious destinations which are majorly dedicated to either Buddhism or Jainism. Both Lord Buddha and Lord Mahavir have said to spend time here, giving it huge spiritual and religious importance. One can visit various ruins, temples and sites there and also spend some time indulging in its refreshing calmness. Next heritage site is Relic Stupa or Vishwa Shanti Stupa, Rajgir. The Relic Stupa was built in 5th century BC. It is 12 meter tall. This is one of the 8 stupas built over the remains of Buddha. This stupa was the small mud stupa measuring only 8.01 meter. Later during the Mauryan, Kushan and Sangha periods, it was increased to 12 meter high. The famous discovery of the stupa is the stone casket with AC earth besides two small beads, copper coin with punch mark, a small conch and a small gold design leaf. The relic is now shifted to Patna. Now Ajatasatru Fort, Rajgir. Ajatasatru was a king and the ruler of the Magad in 16th century BC when he built this grand fort. According to the legend of history, Ajatasatru imprisoned his father Bimbisar in a jail inside this fort after he took the throne. And Bimbisar was a staunch Buddhist, chose a spot from where he could see Lord Buddha give his sermons every morning. The once sturdy and stable fort is now famous for being in ruins and hardly even resembling the magnificent that it once was. Next heritage site is Bimbisar Jail, Maniyar, Rajgir. Bimbisar was the king of Magad from the Hiranya dynasty. He is also known as Srinika or Sinia and was a protector and friend of Buddha. His son betrayed him for the throne of Magad and imprisoned him. King Bimbisar himself decided to place to spend the rest of his life. He picked this place because it was perfect view of Gridhkuta Hill, a place where Buddha was seen going to the hill for meditation. The Bimbisar Jail is located on the southern side of Maniyar Math. It has become a favorite tourist spot for its rich history and a beautiful view of the Japanese Peace Pagoda. The best time to visit Bimbisar Jail is during winter. Next heritage site is Vikramsila, Bhagalpur. Vikramsila University is located in Bhagalpur district in Bihar. It is one of the famous and largest university. Vikramsila University was founded by King Dharampal and was later destroyed by Muhammad bin Bakhtiar Khilji. It was one of the largest universities serving 100 teachers and 1000 students. Many scholars were born in this university and they were invited to spread Buddhism in foreign countries. The university is now ruined and now hosts the famous Vikramsila Mahotsav during the month of February. Next heritage site is Buddha Relic Stupa, Kolua, Vaisali. This is one among the 8 relic stupas built over the corporeal remains of Buddha. The remains were distributed among 8 claimants, one being the Lichwaj of Vaisali. The innermost stupa of a smaller dimensions measuring 8.07 meters in diameter is assignable to circa 5th century. During the rule of the Mauryans and later under Sanghas and Kushans, the stupa was successfully enlarged by brick encasing and by raising the plinth and height of the structure. The excavations have yielded a number of antiquities, among which the relic casket containing ashes mixed with earth, a punch marked coin, some beads and gold objects are the most remarkable discoveries. Next heritage site is Kumrar, ancient Pataliputra, Patna. An ancient city of Pataliputra, it has undergone multiple excavations, operations to underearth ruins like the Assembly Hall, Anand Vihar, Arogya Vihar and Durakhi Devi Temple. This place is just 5 km from Patna railway station and has ruins dating as back as 600 BCE. It has various ruins marking the capital of Ajatasatru, Chandragupta and Ashoka between 600 BCE and 600 CE periods. Next heritage site is Vishwasanchi Stupa, Vaisali. Vishwasanchi Stupa was built by the Buddha Vihar Society, joining hands with the Japanese government. It is a 125 feet piece pagoda built in 1969. It is a white marbled huge stupa with a golden pinnacle on top is surrounded by greenery and ponds. It is located in Vaishali, Bihar. The Sanchi Stupa is the center of all stupa and is one of the oldest structures of India. The structure is hemispherical, built over the relics of Buddha. It is built to promote non-violence and peace across the world. Next heritage site is Patna Museum, Patna. The State Museum of Patna, also known as Jadughar, is a majestic heritage building with historical artifacts of Mughal and Rajput. Patna Museum has fine collection of art objects, paintings, sculptures, instruments and archaeological objects. Next heritage site is Tomb of Sher Shah Suri, Sasaram. Located in Sasaram, Tomb of Sher Shah Suri is the best instance of Indo-Islamic architecture. It has been praised as the honorable samples of Afghan construction in India. It has a brick structure and a portion of it is covered with a stone upright in the center of the fine square tank. It is also worth to visit Hasan Shah Tomb and Salim Shah Tomb and other archaeological buildings at Sasaram. Also known as the second Taj Mahal, Sher Shah Suri Tomb was built between 1540 and 1545. It was built in remembrance of Emperor Sher Shah Suri. It is a perfect example of Indo-Islamic construction. The tomb was designed by Mir Muhammad Aliwal Khan. The tomb is built in red sandstone and is 122 feet high. An artificial lake is built around the tomb. The lake is beautifully decorated with chhatris at the corners. The tomb is octagonal in shape with a dome on top. Next heritage site is Golghar, Patna. Situated in the city of Patna, Golghar is a simple yet charming architecture, which is an amalgam of history and natural beauty. It was built in 1786 by Captain John Garstin with the purpose of serving as a storehouse for the severe famine that occurred in 1770. Incidentally, Golghar was never filled to its maximum capacity, as it is believed that due to an engineering fault, the doors open inwards only, and if the granary were to be filled all the way, the doors will not open. In addition to being a magnanimous granary, the top of Golghar presents a wonderful panoramic view of the city and the Ganges. It is encircled by a flight of 145 stairs that take you all the way up to the top, from where we can see a bird eye view of the entire city. Next heritage site is Ashokan Pillar, Lauriya Nandangarh. Lauriya Nandangarh is a historic town in the state of Bihar and is located at a distance of 22 km from the district of Betia. Lauriya Nandangarh boasts of housing the Ashokan Pillar, which consists of the six Ashokan proclamations. The height of the pillar is more than 12 meters, and even after so many years, the Mauryan polish used on the pillar maintains its radiance and the sheen. The pillar has been inscribed with six Ashokan edicts issued by the emperor in the year 244 BC, and the top of the pillar is adorned with a lion in a crouching position. One of the main tourist attractions of Lauriya Nandangarh is a large stupa, which is believed to be one of the biggest stupa in India. The massive stupa is 24 meter in height and has a circumference of almost 457 meter. Next heritage site is Caves at Barabar Hills. The Caves of Barabar Hills is one of the oldest ancient architecture. It has four caves, Loma Rishi, Sudama, Karan Chopar and Vishwakarma. They are the perfect examples of rock cut architecture in India. Each cave has two chambers made of granites. The cave dates back to 3rd century BCE of the Mauryan period. The interiors of the caves are highly polished with fine scriptures of Buddhism and Hindu religion. The caves also have beautiful temple, giving us an idea about the practice of the religion of the Ajivika sect of Jains and the Buddhist. The caves of the Barabar Hills are internationally famous for the beautiful arches. Next heritage site is Munger Fort, Munger. Munger Fort is one of the most important of the monuments at Munger, built on a rocky hillock on the south bank of Ganges River. The fort houses a number of religious and historic monuments such as Palace of Shah Shuja, Ancient Temple and Tomb of Pir. Other heritage site is Rohtasgarh Fort. The Rohtasgarh Fort was built by Raja Harishchandra and has named it after his son or Hitasa belonging to the Solar dynasty. The fort has four gates built on four ghats. One gate is in Raja Ghat and another in Kautilya Ghat. It is few of the strongest and largest fort in India and is served as a resting place for many emperors' family. Historians believe that this fort has 14 main gates and 84 passages. This fort is too big that it takes about 2 to 3 hours to look around. This fort is located in Rohtas, Bihar. The best time to visit the place is during summer. Next heritage site is Nagar Fort, Madhubani. Nagar Fort is also known as Naulakha Palace. It was built by Maharaja Sri Rameswar Singh. It is one of the ancient forts. The archaeologists have found many artifacts and earthen potteries dating back to 200 BC. It has now been displayed in Hawa Mahal in Jaipur. The fort was beautifully maintained but has since been destroyed by flood and earthquake. The fort is located in Madhubani, Bihar and attracts many historians and archaeologists. Next heritage site is Agam Kuwa, Patna. Agam Kuwa is an ancient well and known to be oldest and the most important archaeological sites in Patna. The 105 feet deep well is situated close to the Gulzarbagh railway station and the complex contains Sitla Devi temple. Next heritage site is Ashokan Pillar, Vaisali. Ashokan Pillar in the ancient city of Vaisali is now an archaeological site and important place for both Jain and Buddhist religions. Notable Buddhist site in Vaisali also includes Kutagrasala Vihar, Anand Stupa, Buddha Asaj Stupa and World Peace Pagoda. Next heritage site is Kesariya Stupa, Kesariya. Kesariya Stupa is a Buddhist stupa in Kesariya, located at a distance of 110 km from Patna in the Champaran district of Bihar. The first construction of the stupa is dated to 3rd century BCE. Kesariya Stupa has a circumference of almost 400 feet and raises to a height of about 104 feet. Considered to be the tallest and biggest Buddhist stupa in the world, Kesariya Stupa was built by the great ruler Ashoka. This is the place where Buddha in his last days donated his begging bowl. The structure serves as a brilliant example of Buddhist architecture and is adorned with a large number of Buddhist statues. However, some of the parts are in ruined state as they were damaged by the invading Muslim rulers. This place was very recently discovered in the excavation done by Archaeological Survey of India. Now Pavapuri Jal Mandir, Nalanda. Pavapuri is a Jain temple in the middle of a lake in the Nalanda district and a holy site for Jains. The Jal Mandir meaning water temple, also known as Apapuri in Pavapuri, meaning a town without sins in the Indian states of Bihar, is a highly revered temple dedicated to Lord Mahavira, the 24th Tirthankar, which marks the place of his cremation. Mahavir attained Nirvana in Pavapuri in 528 BC. Next heritage site, Raj Mahal Fort. Situated on the eastern fringe of Bihar on the western bank of River Ganga, Raj Mahal was founded by Raja Man Singh, the famous 16th century Rajput general in Akbar's army. The Sangi Dalan built on river bank is a part of the palace of Shah Shuja, son of Emperor Shah Jahan. Akbari Mosque was built in 1556 to enable Emperor Akbar to pray. Next heritage site is Palamau Fort, Aurangabad. Two large forts are located deep in the forest of Aurangabad on Sher Shah Suri path. These forts were attributed to the Varanasi kings of the Chero dynasty. It had defenses in three directions and three main gates. The architecture is very Islamic, which best speaks of Daud Khan's conquests. Next heritage site is Maner Fort, Patna. Some centuries ago, Maner was situated on the confluence of the rivers Ganga and Son, and the river Sarayu joined it from the north. The remains of an old-time fortress on the bank of the old channel of the Son reminds one that Maner was a strategic point in the ancient times. Maner holds significant position in Bihar tourist map with the tomb of Sufi Sant Hazrat Makhdum Yahya Maneri on the 13th century. Next heritage site is Noratangarh. भोजपुर किला और राजा भोज किला। इट इज़ लोकेटेड एट नया भोजपुर 19 किलोमीटर ईस्ट ऑफ बक्सर ऑन NH-84। राजा रुद्र प्रताप नारायण सिंह बिल्ट नवरत्नगढ़ फोर्ट आल्सो नोन एज भोजपुर किला और राजा भोज किला इन 1633 CE। इट इज़ सेड दैट देयर वर 52 लेंस एंड 56 डोर्स इन द फोर्ट। अकॉर्डिंग टू फोल्कलोर द फोर्ट यूज टू साइन सो ब्राइट एट नाइट दैट इट वॉज विजिबल फ्रॉम दिल्ली एंड दैट इज वाई द मुगल ऑफिसर अब्दुल्ला खान डिमोलिश्ड इट विद इन 3 years ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड सो देयर आर बेयरली एनी रिमेन्स ऑफ द फोर्ट टूडे। अकॉर्डिंग टू फोल्कलोर राजा भोज ऑफ मालवा मध्य प्रदेश कंक्वायर्ड द एरिया नाउ नोन एज भोजपुर एंड सेटल्ड हेयर। देयर आर रूइंस ऑफ द रीजन बिलीव्ड टू बी द पैलेसेस ऑफ राजा भोज एंड हिज डिसिडेंट्स। नेक्स्ट हेरिटेज साइट इज टॉम्ब ऑफ मखदुम याया मनेरी पटना। मखदुम याया मनेरी वॉज एन इंडियन सूफी संत ऑफ 13th century। हिज टॉम्ब लाइज इन कोर्ट यार्ड ऑफ ए मॉस्क्यू लोकेटेड इन मानेर 29 किलोमीटर फ्रॉम पटना। दिस रीन वॉज रिमेंड ए प्लेस ऑफ पिलग्रिमेज फॉर ए लॉन्ग टाइम। नेक्स्ट हेरिटेज साइट इज बक्सर फोर्ट बक्सर। बक्सर फोर्ट इज ए फोर्ट लोकेटेड इन बक्सर बिहार। बक्सर इज ए सिटी इन द स्टेट ऑफ बिहार इन द ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया बॉर्डरिंग ईस्टर्न उत्तर प्रदेश। इट इज द हेडक्वार्टर्स ऑफ बक्सर डिस्ट्रिक्ट। द फोर्ट वॉज इस्टेब्लिश्ड बाई किंग रुद्रदेव इन 1054। नेक्स्ट इज महात्मा गांधी सेतु पटना। महात्मा गांधी सेतु इज द सेकेंड लॉन्गेस्ट रिवर ब्रिज इन इंडिया द फर्स्ट वन बींग भूपेन हजारिका सेतु इन आसाम। द महात्मा गांधी सेतु इन बिहार एक्सटेंड्स ओवर द गंगेज फॉर 5.7 किलोमीटर्स। इट हैज बीन इनोवेटेड इंजीनियर्ड विथ ओनली 45 पायर्स ऑफ 121 मीटर हाइट लिविंग स्पेस बिलो फॉर द शिप्स। द ब्रिज कनेक्ट्स द कैपिटल सिटी ऑफ पटना इन द साउथ टू हाजीपुर इन द नॉर्थ। दिस ब्रिज हैज बिकम ए लाइफ लाइन गिविंग ए वंडरफुल व्यू एंड सर्विंग टू द पब्लिक एट ए सेम टाइम। द ब्रिज हैज 4 lanes ऑफ रोडवेज एंड पेडेस्ट्रियन पाथवेज ऑन ईच साइड। इट इज एन इंडिस्पेंसिबल पार्ट ऑफ द डेली वेहिकुलर ट्रांसपोर्ट। इट प्रोवाइड सम स्पेक्टुलर व्यूज ऑफ द सेक्रेड गंगा फ्लोइंग अंडरनीथ। सो दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वॉज ऑल अबाउट बिहार हेरिटेज साइट्स। होप दिस प्रेजेंटेशन विल बी हेल्पफुल टू ऑल ऑफ यू। नाउ माई प्रेजेंटेशन इंड्स हियर। थैंक यू वेरी मच। आई हैव गिवन हियर माई यूट्यूब चैनल डिटेल्स जर्नी विद विजय कुमार श्रीवास्तव। हैविंग रिक्वेस्ट प्लीज विजिट द चैनल सब्सक्राइब इट एंड प्रोवाइड योर काइंड एंड वैल्युएबल फीडबैक। थैंकिंग यू।